Chapter 9 Reproduction in Plants. The ways in which plants reproduce. There are three ways in which plants reproduce. Plants reproduce by any one of these three ways. From seeds, from body parts, through spores. First is the reproduction through seeds. Most flowering plants reproduce from seeds are formed in fruits. Seed. Structure of seed. Parts of a seed. Seed coat. It is a outer hard covering of a seed that produces of seed leaves. Seed leaves or cotyledons, this contains food for the body plants or embryo. Embryo, it is a small baby plant that grows into a big plant. That is the parts of a seed. As you know, gram seed. Gram seed, we all know about this. Types of seed. There are two types of seed, monocotyledon and dicotyledon. Monocotyledon seeds like rice, wheat have monocotyledon. They have one cotyledon. As you know about rice and wheat, all you knows about rice and wheat. They are the monocotyledon, dicotyledon. Seeds like pea and bean contain two cotyledons. Germination. Seed germination. What are seed germination? Germination is the growth of a seed into a seedling. Seeds only germinate where they get the suitable conditions of air, water and warmth. Like all other living things, seeds require air to breathe. As we know, we all require air to breathe. Just like us, plants and seeds also require air to breathe. Water softener the seed coat so that the embryo can come out of the seed when it grows. It also helps to change the food plants in the cotyledons to a suitable form which the embryo use. Dispersal. What is dispersal? Seed needs space to germinate. They require air, water, sunlight. Seeds disperse so that they get enough air, water, space and sunlight to grow into a new plant. Dispersal is the scattering of seeds far away from the parent plant. Agent of dispersal. Agent of dispersal is water. Plants that grow near the water have fruits and seeds with spongy and fibrous outer covering that help them to float in water. Coconut has fibrous covering. Lotus seeds are enclosed in a spongy thalamus and are dispersed by water. Next is explosion. The seeds of pea and bean are present inside pots which burst open when ripe, scattering the seeds. Next is the animal. Animal is also agent of dispersal. The fruit of some plants have spikes, hooks or stiff hair that stick to the cloths or humans, to the fur of animal. They drop while the animals move. Xanthium fruit, tiger's nail and spear glass are dispersed in this way. Next is vegetative reproduction. What is vegetative reproduction? Reproduction of plants from their body plant parts is called vegetative reproduction. In these methods, new plants are grown without seeds or spores. Many fruits trees are grown by these methods. The fruits produced are seedless and smaller in size. Vegetative reproduction from stem. Underground stem like onion and ginger. Plants like rose, sugarcane and money plants can grow from them from stem cutting. The stem cutting develop roots when put in moist soil. Next is the from roots. Plants like sweet potato, carrot and wood apple when left in the soil grow into new plants. When the roots of plants like dahlia and asparagus are placed in water, fresh roots develop at the lower end and shoots appear at the upper end. When the root cutting of plant like lemon, tamarinds come in contact with the moist air, a new plants develop. From leaves, plants like biophyllum and begonium have small buds and leaflets on the margin of their leaves. When the buds come in contact with moist soil, new plants grow. Tea origination. What is tea origination? As we all know about tea, many people like to drink tea. It is prepared in different ways in different parts of India. In Kashmir, green tea is made with crushed almond peas and is called kahwa. The people of Ladakh make strong tea with green tea, salt and yolk butter. The Chinese were the first to start growing tea thousands of years ago for its medical value and taste. After that, the Japanese started cultivating tea. Tea cultivation started in Assam and India in 1828. Tea is an evergreen plant which grows in places at the height of 1000 and 2000 meter. It is continuous stream to keep it to a height of 2-3 meters so that it is easy to pluck its leaves. It requires a lot of water and is grown on hilly areas so that extra water can get drained away. Standing water damages and plants. It requires warm weather and many hours of sunshine. In India, it is grown in Assam, Darjeeling and in the Nilgiris. Thank you, and repeat, read this chapter 2 times.